Hello everyone, this is Diane. I am continuing my series on the Book Readers Journals Start to Finish series, and today is the day we get to start sewing in our signatures. I did say that the next video might be making ephemera to put into the pockets, but I've already filled the pockets. I don't think a video is necessary because basically I'm just using vintage book images from children's books and backing them onto cardstock or lined paper or something and putting them in the pockets. I'm not making anything fancy. The journal, the tags that I made in, like these tags that I made in some previous videos, they're the fanciest thing I'm putting in. So we are just going to go right to sewing in the signatures. So I have my three signatures. I have my book cover. What I do is I make a template by cutting a piece of paper. This is just a piece of copy paper, lightweight copy paper. And I cut it the same width as my spine, which in this case is 2 inches. And then not the height of the book cover, but the height of the paper, the pages, because my pages are always a little bit shorter than the book cover. I don't make them the same. And my book cover is 7 3/4 inches. Right? I think that's what I did. Yeah, 7 3/4 inches. So that's what this paper is, 2 inches by 7 3/4. Now, I always use an odd number of signatures because that way the center signature goes right in the middle of the spine, and it makes it a lot easier to space them out evenly. Most of the time, I'm doing 3 signatures. So in order to mark my template, I fold my template in half lengthwise, and then I open it up and I take one edge and fold it to the center. And then I take the other edge and fold it to the center. And then I have 3 evenly spaced folded lines. And then I fold it in half lengthwise. So now I have 3 vertical lines, evenly spaced, and 1 horizontal line. So I use a five hole pamphlet stitch where the center line, well, where the vertical and the horizontal lines intersect, that is the center hole for each signature. So I used a fine marker, and any pen or pencil would do that. I wanted to be able to see it, so I used a black marker. And I just make a little dot where those lines intersect, okay? And then I'm going to need 2 marks on either side of the center mark. So I have 5 holes all together on each line. So I have a centering ruler with the 0 in the middle, and then it goes out 1, 2, 3. This makes it easy. You can use any kind of ruler if you want. But I put my 0 mark right where the dot is, where those two lines met, okay? And I see that it goes to almost 4 inches to the end. So I am going to make my holes at 1.5 and 3. And there's a little bit of space between the last stitch and the top of the book or the bottom of the book. So I marked on all of the lines. We already have the 0 marked, and then I marked 1.5 and 3 and 1.5 and 3. And then I move it to the next line and again mark 1.5 and 3. I did that before I turned the camera on because I have to get my face pretty close to it so that I can see the lines properly. I don't have very good vision. So I'm hoping that I will be able to do this tutorial of sewing the signatures in without getting my head in there. Then I take my paper and I just write top, or just make a T or something at the top so that you will hold this template the same direction every time you're using it on any of your signatures or cover. First thing I'm going to do is punch the holes in my spine. So we can do this a couple of ways. Now, this paper is shorter than my book cover because I made it the same height as my pages. And that is because if I had made it the height of the book, then I may have made my end marks too close to the edge. And it would have been too close to the edge of the paper or even off the page. So that's why I use the pages themselves as a guide for my template. So I just kind of center it, just eyeball it, so that there's the same space between the top and the bottom. I'm going to do it the way I always do it. I'm going to take my pokey tool. This is a Tim Holtz Tonic Studios. I'm not even sure what the name of it is, but I also have this from Stampin' Up. And that did have a little rubbery tube to fit over there, but I lost that. But I use either one. Whatever one is handy is what I use. So I'm just going to poke my holes in my paper. So I'm going to poke it, and then I'm going to just kind of wiggle it to make the hole bigger, big enough that I can put a pen point through it. And I'll just do that for all of my holes. Oops. And this is for sewing in a signature. Where you will be able to see the stitches on the outside of the book. Maybe another time I will do it with where the stitches will be hidden. Okay, all the holes are punched in there now. So I'm going to take my pen and lay this down. And again, eyeball it so that there's the same space at the top and the bottom. And this is centered. It's in there. All right, and then hold it still. And then just put your pen through the holes. Make sure it's going through. Yep. So I've got three black dots there. This one is easy because it's a white fabric. Sometimes. Now, this line is right on that green stitching. So I'm just going to make the mark a little darker. And I can see it. Sometimes your fabric is dark. And so it's hard to do that. So in that case, I would clip my template to the top and the bottom of my spine and poke the holes right through the template. But I find that I have a hard time holding the template in place to do that. So it's easier for me to mark it with pen. I'm not saying that this is the common way to do this. I'm saying this is my way of doing it. So I've got my little black marks, and now I will take my same pokey tool and just poke through. I'm holding it up off the table. Some people have a foam or something that they can poke it right through, but I don't have anything like that. Making sure my fingers on the back there are kind of supporting the spine but are not near the hole that is being poked. That would be a bad thing. Now I'll just flip it around so that my fingers can support this end. I think I caught on a pretty sturdy thread there, but we got it through. Okay, now we need to poke some holes in the signature. So this is my first signature that I will be putting in there. I'm going to remove all of the ephemera that I have tucked in. And while I go through and take out ephemera, I'm making sure that all my pages are where I want them. So this page is slightly shorter. I'm just making it so that there's a little bit of leeway on both sides of it. It doesn't really matter. There's another page that's shorter. Sometimes you want your page closer to the top and maybe the next one closer to the bottom. Just however you want them. Make sure they're lined up the way you want them. So I put the book page closer to the top, and so I'll put this one closer to the bottom. I've gotten to the center, so I'm going to take a clip, a binder clip, and I'm holding it so that all the pages are pressed down into the center there. And I'm just going to clip this on the bottom. And then I will go back. All the pages should be lined up now. I'm just going to remove any remaining ephemera so they don't fall out or anything like that. Okay. And I will clip this one at the top over here. I used to put a binder on all four sides, front and back, top and bottom, but I find that just having one at the top back and one at the front bottom or something like that, as long as you got two clips on there like that, it works. So now I'm going to take my template and I'm going to put it so that the center line is right there, right in that fold. And I'm going to punch some holes. I kind of fold my book cover, my book pages together. And that kind of ensures that the hole is going to come right out through that fold. So that was perfect, coming out through the hole. Through the fold. Sometimes it looks like it's in the center here, but by the time it comes out here, it might come out a little bit to the front or the back. So I just kind of keep an eye on that. Just make sure I'm still in the right spot and poke through there. That's good. Flip it around. They all came out through the fold. I'm going to set this aside and this aside, and we will get to work sewing the signature in. When I did the chicken journals following the Amity Bloom course, the everyday journal, I used crochet thread that I ran through my beeswax. I have this color, and then at Hobby Lobby I found this pink and this green. So I might get a few more colors of it, and I don't want to just have these bulky things in my supplies of my box that I used for my sewing signatures together supplies. So I picked up these little Yarnology from Hobby Lobby plastic floss bobbins. So I can just unspool a bunch of this. And there's little slots to catch it in at the beginning and the end. and wind your floss around there, and there are 25 in there for 99 cents. So that wasn't bad. So I'm going to work on that while I'm watching TV some night. But that was a seven signature journal that I did this, use this. So this is only 3 signatures, and so there are more pages, and the signatures are heavier because there's more pages and pockets and tags in each signature. So I'm just going to do what I have done for years, and that is to use this heavier waxed cord. I am going to use my colored crochet thread in future journals, but I know that for this one, this is made the way I've made journals for many years. So this is a waxed cord that I get at Walmart. You can get it in jewelry departments or jewelry making sections in the craft stores and at Walmart. It is a wax coated linen thread. So I am just going to measure it the length of my page 3 times, and that is more than you need, but it's not that expensive, so it's better to have more than you need and then throw a chunk of it away than to cut yourself short. So this is what I had left over from the last time I made one. So I always keep it in there so that I throw all my supplies in this box. And hey, look, this is the thing that goes on this. I didn't know it was right in that box. That is much safer. Okay, so this way the thread is on it and I can find the needle more easily. I should have a better system, I know. I should have a little container, a little tin or a box to put my little needles in. I have other needles floating around in there, and I always want to make sure this is the one, because this one works well for me, and I don't want to have to fuss with any others. So I've threaded my needle. I am going to, if I want my cord to be tied inside the journal, I will start in here. If I want to tie it off out here, which you can tie it off and leave some threads and put some beads on them or something, but I usually do mine so it's inside. So you start inside. If you want to tie it on the outside, you start out there. So I start in the center, and I start with the front row. So there's the center front hole, and I will just put my needle down through there and pull it out. And just make sure you don't pull it all the way. I leave a decent amount, a decent length of thread. And then I come up or down. It doesn't matter which way you go. I think I usually just go up out of force of habit, put my needle in, and then find the next hole in the signature and put your needle back through there. I do have this for sometimes I get a needle that is stubborn, or the fabric is tough and doesn't want to give up the end of the needle, and I will use that to pull it through. I don't think this is going to give us a problem. It seems to be pulling through quite easily. So just a pair of pliers in my box comes in handy. And then I continue up to the next hole, and then the next hole on the spine, and pull it through the back. And while you're working, every now and then just pull on the loose thread and the thread with this threaded through the needle, and just pull them in opposite directions just to tighten everything up. Do not pull too hard. I have broken the threads by doing that. Even though they're a nice waxed linen cord, they break when you pull on them too hard. So just slightly, you know, just tug on them enough to get the stitches to tighten up. Now I'm going to go back down, and then we have to do the other end. So I'm going down to the second hole, sometimes I have to open or close the signature so I can find where the hole is. There it is. Okay, now there's a hole here in the middle where we started. I'm going to skip that and go right down to the hole that's beyond that, going on down. Skip the middle and go down past it to the next hole, and then come up through the back. This is loose right here, so I just pull that other string and it comes tight. Then I go down to the very bottom hole. It's hard to see the hole, but I can feel it with my finger where the cardboard has a little disruption where the hole is. And there I am. Put it through the last hole in the signature. And then pull it through and bring it taut. And then back up to the last hole that you did, going back up toward the center. And now we are going to go into the middle hole again, where we started. So I just want to point out, here is the thread, the stitches. Here's the loose thread, and it's on this side of the stitch. It's on the left side of the stitch, and I want to make sure I come up on the right side of the stitch. And if you don't, if you come up on the wrong side, it's okay. You can thread it under, just to make sure that your thread is in the center of those two stitches, so that when you tie your knot, you're catching that stitch in there. So I'm coming up to the center hole, and it will come up there. And I've guided it so that it's coming off to the right. And like I said, if I ended up coming up on the same side, all I would do is slip the needle underneath that thread and pull it through to get it to the side I want it on. So there I have it. All the threads look tight. Nice and tight, and I just take my thread here and tie it in a knot. There are some things you can do to this center thread here. You can tie it in a bow just to make it look prettier. You can cut it short just to have, and you'd have a couple of little threads hanging there. You could put some beads at the bottom of it. If I was going to do that, I would leave my thread longer so the beads would hang out of the book. But I have seen people have little thin charms or beads hanging on their book that are still inside. Sometimes I leave the thread semi-long and then I glue little pieces of paper that are punched out in the shapes of flowers or banners or whatever, circles, hearts, and you glue one on the front and one on the back together, and it leaves a little decorative edge. I might do that with these, but I probably won't do that in this video. Maybe, we'll see. So I'm going to cut it right there. Another thing you can do is if you had an envelope in the center, which I do quite often. So pretend that this is an envelope instead of a card. You would have your envelope all opened up like that. And then after you sew your signature in, you would cut your threads, and then you would glue your envelope closed, and then the threads would be, the knot would be hidden inside the envelope and you wouldn't see it. But this is a note card, and I'm going to leave it open. So I might just put some things, glue some paper things on there. But do you need me to do that one more time with the starting in the middle and then going up and then going down and then going back up? Let's do it again. Oh, I also wanted to let you know how I put things back in. So these are the order that I took them out in reverse, right? So this is the one I took out first. So I just go back through backwards, and that helps me remember where I got them from. Some people don't put their ephemera pieces in until after it's all done, but I like to have all my ephemera selected and put in, so it just helps me to see how thick the book is getting before I make my cover. In this case, I know I made my cover before I made the signatures, but I kind of had an idea. Most of my book covers are 2 inches wide. So this is just how I do it. Like I said, I'm just showing you the way I do it. Oh, this goes on the front. I remember that. And this goes inside the front pocket, but I'm going to put that in later. So, let's do the next one. I probably don't need to take this out because it's pretty secure in that great big pocket. It probably wouldn't fall out, but I'm taking it out anyway. You will look at all the ephemera, the journaling cards, etc. that I put in these when I do the final flip through, which should be the very next video. So I just make sure, once I have it all clipped on, I just use my fingers to make sure that it feels like all of the papers are together. Sometimes got a little piece of hair stuck in there. It's caught in my clip. Now I don't see it. Oh, well. Oh, there it is again. So I just make sure that all the paper is setting right down into the fold all together. And this one feels really good. Sometimes it just feels loose. And I will just open a clip and press it, and then put the clip back on, and that usually fixes it. Oops, that is the wrong template. Okay, here we are. So I have the top up there. That's the top of the signature. And they should be evenly spaced, so it shouldn't matter, but it does matter because there might be something a little bit off, and so if I put this one this way and punch my holes and sewed it in, it might be a little bit higher or a little bit lower than this one. So that's why I always make sure that I punch the holes with this paper going the same direction. So again, I'm just going to punch my holes. My thread 3 times the length of my signature. And thread my needle. Okay. Make sure you have your book facing, your signature facing the same way. I have had to take it all out because I put it in upside down before. So this is facing up. And I'm going to start in the middle again on the inside. Put the needle through. and put the needle through the center hole in the middle row of dots. And there's one more row beyond here for the third signature. Now, where's the center here, or the hole here? This one is, I can't really feel the ridge in the cardboard, so sometimes we have to do this. I can see it marked with my pen, so I can take my poker and poke it through again. Sometimes take a look to see where it comes out here. It should be a nice fresh hole and I should be able to see it. Sometimes the fabric the threads of the fabric seem to close around the hole. That dark leaf is making it difficult for me to see the hole. So I'm going to do that again, and I'm going to have to, I do this when I'm using fabric covers a lot. I can see right there where it comes out. So I'm going to take it out and I can see the hole right there. I can put my needle through it. But why isn't it going through? There. Okay, now when you're fiddling around like this, you really have to be careful not to pull that thread all the way through. Okay, got my needle in there, and I'm going to put it in the next hole going up in the signature. It's good that things like that happen while I'm filming so that you can see, you know, some things you can do to help out with difficulties like that. Going up to the next hole, the topmost hole, and then the top hole of the center row of stitches. Make sure you pull your threads taut. Now I'm going to go back down to this hole that gave us trouble. I can glue that. It's a little loose right there. I can glue that if I want to, but the thread will hold it secure. I'm going to go right in that hole and check something out here. Why do I have two threads there? Because I don't know. I think I got twisted around a thread, so I'm going to, I've never had that happen before. Let's see here. Yeah. Don't pull that one out. I'm going to have to pull this one out because for some reason it went through that one and my needle fell out. Well, this is a fun tutorial, isn't it? Okay, I'm going to put my needle back in. And we're already through that troublesome hole, so that's good. So I'm this far going into the second hole. See, I must have gone through there somehow. I've never done that before. I'm so glad you got to see me do that, she said sarcastically. Okay, now this is where we were, and when I realized that I had made a mess, make sure the threads are taut, and then go back to that hole, the second hole down, and come up into the signature. I'm going to pass over the center hole and go down to this hole that is the second from the bottom. I'm sure it's faster and easier to do a three-hole pamphlet stitch, but it is not that much harder or time consuming to do five holes. And so I would rather do the five hole and be more secure. It's just my thought. It's just how I've always done it. And I don't want to switch to a three signature or a three hole just to do it faster. And now I'm going to go back up. I was talking. I hope you could see what I was doing. Down into that hole. And then up into the middle hole, the center. Coming up on the other side of my string. Came a little too far inland. Sometimes it helps to... My needle stuck. It helps to close the signature up so you can actually see the needle going into the hole where you want it to. Okay, I'm going to show you because it's coming up on the other side, and rather than fix that where I was, I'm going to show you how to fix it if you're already up here. So both sides of my thread are over here. I'm just going to put my needle underneath that thread. I don't want to pull up on the thread and loosen it, but I just kind of slide it in there, and now it's on both sides. And now I can tie it off. And before I end the video, I'm going to just add an embellishment to the ends of those strings, like I was talking about, because I have one more signature to sew in, but I'm going to do it the exact same way. And then I will have three signatures in there. And it will be done, except for whatever finishing touches I need to do. And one of the finishing touches would be if I wanted to decorate the ends of those threads. So, I have some little punches. I do have a little heart punch, which I could use. And I also have these little flowers, which I do, and the little banner and that little shape. I think I'm going to go with this shape today. So I often will take a scrap of whatever scrapbook paper I used in the journal. Let me find a scrap. Wasn't really planning on doing this step, but... Okay, I've got paper right here. These are my cutoff pieces. And I'm going to... Just to do it quickly, I'll take this one. And I'm going to punch out four of these. And that will take care of this signature. And then I will take a little dab of glue. You can use glue stick. And put it all over your piece, and then lay the end of your string down in the middle of that, and then take another one and lay it on top and press it. And when that dries, you just have that little... I think it would have looked better if I'm going to do it the other way. Reapply the glue. Going to do it the long way. I think that'll look better. I put the string down in there more than halfway just so it's secure in there and doesn't pull out easily. and press that together. And there, that does look better that way. That's just a little decorative piece for your string. You can do it with the same scrapbook paper or copy dyed paper or whatever you want to use. You can do the same paper for all three or change it up. This matches this page here. That's a green, so maybe I would use this one. So you get the idea. I have one more signature to sew in, and then my finishing touches would usually include making sure I have all of my ephemera pieces backed or inked, whatever I wanted to do to them, making sure there's seam binding or ribbon through my tags if I want to do that, putting a book plate on it if I want to put a book plate on. I don't know if I want to in this because I like that it says the Music Hour fourth book, which is what this is. If I have an envelope in the center, I would glue that, or I would embellish the string somehow or tie it in a bow or whatever I want to do. So I just flip through, I pull out my pieces, so I make sure I'm not going to back this one at all because I wanted both pictures to show. But I just make sure that all of the finishing touches are done. And then I will end by, usually I have a pocket on the back, and I will put my little stamp that I sign with my signature on a card that I tuck into that pocket, but I'm not going to cover this up. So this is my book, so I don't need to sign it, but I would put my stamp with my signature on a card in the back of the book, and that would complete my journal. Unless I wanted to add a closure or just tie something around it, you know, whatever, however you want to finish it. I think for these, I might just tie seam binding around them. So there you go. That concludes the series, except for the final flip through. And I hope you'll come back to see the final flip through. And when that happens, the journal will be in my shop. This one I'm keeping. I have to sew this one together in just the same manner that I sewing that one. And this one will be in my shop when you see the video. So thank you for watching. I hope that this series was helpful to you and informative. You can save it to a playlist, create a playlist on your YouTube channel that says start to finish hardcover journal or whatever. And so save all these videos into that playlist so you can refer to it. And other people's videos too. You know, whatever videos you have for journal construction that you like, of any type of journal, put them into one playlist so that you can refer to them. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a creative day today, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.